So thank you very much for giving this, chance. Appreciate. My presentation is the measure to mitigate this coronavirus pandemic in the application to national security with good lesson learned in the practice. My content is already, you can view on that, a few content. Maybe for the sake of saving time, human leadership versus COVID-19, how you manage this complex pandemic, security vulnerability in the emerging from this pandemic, comparative review with non-traditional of internal law, the law enforcement, how the law enforcement is related with this pandemic, and how or widely why this armed force engagement in this to mitigate this this pandemic, and that there is a potential opportunity in the hazard for armed force to mitigate, and a small conclusion, and I also the reference. So virus is mainly greatest challenge for all of us next to the worldwide second, especially this emergency in Asian last year, the virus spread over the continent, which affect all human being. Additionally, this pandemic is a health crisis, stressing everyone in the country, and every people are losing their job income with knowing how the normality will return back in future, inshallah. Small island river nation is very dependent on tourism, are highly affected, especially the ILO, International Labour Organization, also estimates this million of job will be lost because of this pandemic. My second topic is making choose managing complexity in the uncertain of this pandemic. Drawing on our experience and the outbreak of, for example, in Ebola, HIV, SARS, TB, and the malaria, long history, the UNDP report this COVID is mitigating and how it is affecting the poverty and the reduced inequality, which is very for again, regarding to this crisis, to design the first beyond the recovery, especially up to 2030, making use with complexity, especially the governance, the social protection, the green economy, the disruption of digital, which is highly very important. You can see the slide which is I am putting on that. Especially, I propose different making choosing, which is maybe handled with other stakeholder. I only point out on number six. Maybe you can see the arrow, the peaceful, resilient institution in the society, which is a capable of prevention. In the preparedness of the risk management to manage this pandemic disease. The others are maybe inclusive diversity, which is handling by other stakeholder, especially the social contract, also capability with others in the human rights, in the multilateralism will also a part in the parcel of this recovery in the emerging tip for this disease. But my point is, and the bottom line is the peace, peaceful, resilient institution, which in the society will be capable to prevent this disease. Again, there are four areas which we will going to mitigate this pandemic disease, especially for military security. One point is the governance system. Other one is the social protection system, and the participation on green economy and the digital disruption. As you see on picture, it is a very clear that in this all the military force will participate in one way or another protecting this pandemic disease in the community. This disease pandemic is an existential threat to human security, especially which is very bad for personnel killed. And pandemic, this is risky to regional stability and the security, not only for the country. The spread of this pandemic is again very restrict measuring, closing border, even putting restriction on travel, shutting down the business, enforcing total lockdown, which is hampering the total political trajectory in the economy of a given country, especially those of developing country, for example, like my country, Ethiopia. Government also failed to provide necessary public care for this pandemic, which is given to political system for in future. The inability of government, particularly in developed country, maybe swiftly have the capability to handle this problem. But the risk for developing country, it is a volatile, higher in weak state, especially those of lack of a strong administrative structure, very difficult for them. Again, this pandemic can also create an environmental stability for especially those of terrorist group to capitalize their own interest on a community. In this regard, the COVID has laid bare lack of preparedness when it is erupted in the world, which exposed how the vulnerable the government is potential for this terrorism. Again, in other side, we can see from securitization perspective, the government is very active in this extraordinary measure. Likewise, citizens also willing to temporarily give up the civil liberty, especially those of human security perspective. In fact, viewing the pandemic as a national and a global security, which is very difficult to control within a short period of time. This virus pandemic is demonstrated traditional security paradigm, especially for against human security, the well-being citizen, which is difficult. Therefore, the new and appropriate strategy will be needed to adopt for our security forces. Another very important is the security vulnerability emerging from coronavirus pandemic. One question may raise, how COVID hinders the security perspective? This virus has triggered a number of chain reduction of border closure around the world. This is truly an ordinary situation. Many of the country have information when this pandemic is erupted. Even many countries have a lack of information, resource, coordination among different agencies, which is again a very security vulnerability. The operational issue raised from different global activity, again, very difficult for security perspective. There are many ways disease can threaten to national security. First, the cause increased rate of morbidity, especially the mortality rate of people which is sick and die, putting huge strain on public health, especially in order to protect the people, leading the political instability, class strife, and the economy volatility. This is a very problem in national security. So my intention, the bottom line is this disease is threatened to national security, needed the collaborative strategy among the stakeholders. At the end of the Cold War, especially, the political expectation needs the downsizing increased military and the defense spending. Look at, this is a very paradox, which is there is a peace dividend in one direction, again, downsizing of the military, including the defense spending. But to defend this disease, the organized body is the military one. The military has a lot of capability in its own hand, which has to mitigate this one, even including war on terror, to deter, which is role of the armed forces. Another very important is the comparative review of this non-traditional internal role in the task. contrary to the popular and the traditional conception, armed force mission, there is a problem, an internal role, task, which is performed by all branch of security forces. For example, including law enforcement, when this kind of disease is already interrupted to the non-traditional in a country, including environmental protection, medical support for community, support of training in a youth, border surveillance, provision of security, especially food, energy, and transportation, which is very difficult for weak government or which is government unable to afford this kind of support for a community. Security provision and replacement of vital service during this kind of stoppage of an economic disruption. Also, there is a counterterrorism using this kind of an opportunity when the people are captured with this kind of disease. The people the terrorism, the smugglers, traffickers are doing this opportunity, especially the anti-drug operations. Even the security kind of and illegal crimes, even communication, computers, internet, at these times the people are helping. So this kind of supporting, for example, enforcement agencies who don't have such kind of enforcement to protect. Another very important is the law enforcement related task for mitigating this kind of disease. The core function of armed force, especially in public order, which is during the civil disobedience, disorder, during such a kind of a disease, especially limited riots, strikes. This kind is very difficult. Again, counterterrorism, which is domestic counterterrorism role, is expanded during this COVID and other related disease. Border control is also difficult for law enforcement mechanisms. Again, drug enforcement is also limited for security forces at this period of time. Even including law enforcement are also difficult. Searching the risk is very difficult for security perspective, especially during this COVID-19. For example, in highland areas, there is a high erosions, man-made problems, and the natural problems. At that time, searching the risk for a military is very difficult for them. Support for major public event, building in the personal security, cyber operation, disaster relief are all very difficult, and the law enforcement related tasks are very difficult for military. Again, widely shared reason behind why armed force engagement in this kind of internal law. This is because of internal national security perspective. The first and the most is to assist delivery service for the government, especially for civilian public, which is very important for. The second very important is the armed force is comparatively has a good advantage in possession of proper equipment, experience, manpower, especially in the evacuation procedures. The third is helping the nation, which is all over for the society along the region. Another very important is the potential, the hazard for internal role. The hazard for granting, especially the hazard for granting force, is the prominence of internal role may include a fear of losing civilian control over the force. Because during pandemic, disease by itself is controlling the community, while the military force doesn't have enough capability to controlling and capability of this unwanted in the anti-peace element in controlling such kind of. Therefore, eroding in principle of separating civilian in the military authority is very important at this period of time. Therefore, the potential misconduct, abuse by armed force due to improper training for internal deployment also may hazard at that time. Because if there is no proper training for military, for security, handling these people because of maybe the culture, because of the people, the way they live, which is difficult. Again, lack of local understanding and the sensitivity. Investing armed force in dual internal and external law because of the financial, because of the capability of the government. Again, it is also very difficult for the government. There is also a good opportunity for them in contrast to the number of opportunity may raise, there is the armed force internal role, especially provision of important peacetime contribution to a safety and the security. For example, natural disaster in the widespread of civilian disturbance. So at this period of time, deterrence again, in society experience also armed force has been characterized by depletion. This is also a good opportunity for armed force for controlling this. Special learning can be learned from countries where armed force and the other security institution, state and the society had to adapt a new security challenge. For example, in my country, there is a good lesson practice. The armed force is well organized to protect such a kind of pandemic disease while protecting a different disruption in the community. It is absolutely crucial, in addition to armed force accommodating in terms of accountability, such as civilian oversight in the internal command structure is also a good lesson learned. Armed force survived for this, particularly for this article or my presentation. Internal security provision is very important, including resource for this security. Again, subsidiary operational activities, command control, civilian agencies also very important as a lesson learned. Internal armed conflict also diminishing perception of population and their political representative. At that time, the command control should be very important to control this kind of disease in the related anti-peace elements. Again, change in armed force regime, especially division role, should be very important. The society should be very aware, which is establishing national law and the custom, which is mainly affecting the national security in the very practice. So, in my reference also, I use different kind of reference when I collect and preview these practically for Albert Scamper, mapping involving internal role of armed force during this kind of things, changing the nature of military role, especially experience in Europe, practices of human security agenda, and the rethinking security after the Cold War is my reference in consolidating this kind of presentation. I hope I present my review very precise. If I take so many times, I'm asking you an excuse. This is all my presentation, my friend. Thank you very much.